something in Nigeria, we say we die here, meaning this is it. This is what I'm going to do. So that was my we die here moment. Like, I'm in for it and I'm in all the way.
There's, well, yeah. What an interesting way to phrase that. Hello, everyone. Welcome to Educative Sessions, a podcast series with people in the developer world about their coding experiences. This is powered by Educative, which makes it easy for authors to provide interactive and adaptive courses for software developers. My name is Lingo, and today's guest is Daphnie Ozioma. Wow, I just practiced so many times and I didn't stick the landing. Daphnie Ozioma, who is a front-end developer and also a contributor to the Edpresso platform on Educative. And today we're going to talk about code and microorganisms and her career from a microbiologist into code. Daphnie, thank you so much for being on our show.
Hi, Lee.
Hello, hello. And thank you so much for joining us from Nigeria as well. I know, like, big time differences, a lot of challenges, but we're making it work. So let's get right into it. You graduated in 2018 with a degree in microbiology. So what made you jump from that really illustrious career to something else instead?
Okay, so in my penultimate year, 2017, mm-hmm. I had a conversation with two friends who were starting a girl bootcamp on campus for students by students, and they tried to convince me to get into tech. And at that time, I thought tech was all about coding. So yeah. They let me see that I already held managerial positions on campus, and they helped me see that project management is a field I would fit into perfectly based on all the things I've been handling for the department and from the societies I was involved in. So I was like, you know what, after school, I'm going to give this a try. I went online, I did a lot of research, and I realized that this field is for me. Now, the real driving force for me was that, unfortunately, in Nigeria, if you study microbiology, you are most likely going to end up a teacher. The job market is this thing.
Like, not even as a, not there's not a lot of work in research or anything like that? You just go
our research industries are dead. No.
Wow, okay.
Nope. Yeah. So I was all about, okay, after school, what next? I just didn't want to be at home doing nothing. I'm used to being agile. So when I graduated in 2018, I started looking for opportunities. Luckily, there was a girl lead bootcamp that was taking girls interested in any field of tech. So I applied, took the test exam. The previous year, 2017, I think it was about 25,000 naira. At that time, the exchange rate was about $250. So I saved up the money, ready to go into it. Luckily, in the year I applied, the US consulate sponsored for 50 girls that year, and I was among the lucky 50 to get into project management. And that was how I got into project management.
Got you. So that's amazing. I mean, you feel very honored and proud, like, to have such an opportunity to get into project management that way. And yet, like, when you were in project management, let's just be honest, it wasn't maybe a great fit for you, right? There are some things about it that you were still hungry to explore about yourself. So, you know, now you're a coder. So what was that transition like? You know, what did you have to understand about yourself as a project manager that made you want to get into coding?
Unfortunately, I never had the opportunity to be a project manager. When I got into the bootcamp in February 2019, mm-hmm. turns out that they didn't have a project manager tutor available. So the other tracks available was software development, design and data, I think data analytics or something like that. Mm-hmm. And I do not, as at that time, I thought I did not have eye for design. And I didn't want to go into data science because I thought data science was all about charts and maths, and I didn't want to do that.
Right.
So the next thing was software development. My best friend, who is a full stack developer, encouraged me, and he was like, you know what, Daphnie, just try it. Never can tell, you may love it. If you do, after this 3 months, I'm always around to teach you. So I gave it a shot. I think my first class, it was basically 1 week every week for 12, 1 day in the week, every week for 12 weeks, because it was for students. And we also had to deal with, although I was a graduate at the time, the students who were teaching us also had to go to classes and still show up to teachers. Right. So I remember my first experience with HTML, and I had my index on HTML. I wrote jargons and I saw it on my browser and I was intrigued, like, what?
Sure.
This is magic. Come on. And I learned CSS and I added CSS and I was like, oh my God, this is fantastic. Mm-hmm. And I was like, you know what? There's something in Nigeria, we say we die here, meaning this is it. This is what I'm going to do. So that was my we die here moment. Like, I'm in for it and I'm in all the way.
There's, well, what an interesting way to phrase that. But, you know, what a new cultural revelation. But that's so cool. I mean, I think it's wonderful that you had like that kind of moment, and a moment that made you fall in love. That's what discovering passion is supposed to feel like, you know? And so as you are proceeding, you know, tell me a little bit more about like where you are now, you know, professionally, right? You've transitioned out of, are you still doing project management to an extent, or are you
now? I never did project management. I never had the opportunity to.
Oh, so you never actually did it. So you actually, it just never came up for you. Okay, that's interesting.
Okay, so this is how it went.
Yeah.
So after the bootcamp, I was like, I spoke to my best friend who was at that time working with a startup, a health tech startup, but I needed an internship to solidify my skills because I was just introduced to JavaScript as at the time the bootcamp ended. So he hooked me up with a 3-month internship where he was working. Mm-hmm. Then that was when reality dawned on me. I was able to see how what I'm doing is affecting lives. Got into the internship, started learning JavaScript, had my first contact with AngularJS, and that was a horrible experience for me because as at that time, it was just overwhelming. And I was like, no, I mean, this is for the long run. So even if I don't understand Angular, I'm going to look for something that I understand. And he taught me React.js. Yeah. I picked up, then to the tail end of 2019 was my, okay, there's this scheme in Nigeria called the NYSC, National Youth Service Corps. It's where all graduates go for a paramilitary training for three weeks. Then they send you to the field, in any field at all relevant to your course, where you basically work for your company to have corporate experience, at the same time serve the country. So being a microbiologist, I was supposed to serve in a school to teach biology, of course. Mm-hmm. But I didn't want that. I felt like 1 year of my life is going to be the climax of everything that will happen to my career after graduation. So I sent my CV, my very scanty CV, of course, to some tech firms in the city capital. And I think I had two very amazing feedbacks because over here, the ratio of girls to boys is like 1 in 100 during tech. So many people want, the two companies had their HRs reach out to me and they're like, you know what, let's train you. So I got into where I currently work for, I interned with them sort of for like 11 months where, I mean, I got into the real drill of software development and my passion woke up again. Waking up in the morning, having meeting front end, that's when I even knew what front end and back end was. Front end, back end, meeting together, bringing things to life. And I was like, so funny enough, deep down, I still want to be a project manager. Mm-hmm. So I drew myself a 5-year career path. I plan to spend 2 years in front end, 2 to 3 years in front end. Mm-hmm. I also want to go into back end. I really want to know how those people think. Just don't wake up and give me an API to consume or tell me this is what the database looks like. I want to know how you build that database. So in the next 2 to 3 years, I really want to go into back end. Then a little bit of DevOps. I want to understand what goes on there. And at the end of it all, I still want to be a project manager. Maybe this time, because of my experiences, I'll be a technical project manager. Mm-hmm. But it's still my life dream to be a project manager. I have managerial skills that I intend to use and I must use.
Mm-hmm. Interesting. Yeah. I think, you know, what's wonderful is that you're already thinking about a long-term path for your own career. And a lot of people, maybe when they want to do a thing, they want to do it right away. Things like project management or product management take a lot of time because you have to at least understand the nuances of, you don't have to know, I don't think in my view, exact code, but you have to understand how coders work and think in order to work alongside them, right? And you know, what I love about what you shared is that you are still growing and you are recognizing what you do know and don't know, and that's your next step. See, to me, that's wonderful to me that you are completely aware of your own journey, and that's very difficult for a lot of people, you know. Would you agree with that?
I do agree a lot.
Well, I want to know more about you, but I think the one thing, you know, we're running low on time, so I guess I want to give you the rest of the time to talk about specifically what you're working on, whether you know, it's at your company. I know you mentioned that you did a big thing today or in the last week, or some cause or particular interest. You really, the floor is yours for you to share something to the community.
Okay, so currently at Flexisaf, where I work as a front-end developer, we just rebuilt our parent app. It's a school management software called Saxings, and we did a beta launching yesterday. It's currently only available for testers, but it's a school management software. What it does is it bridges the gap between the classroom and the parents. So we have a portion for the administrative guys where you compile your students' results, you take attendance, you release the assignments on the platform. For the teachers, you just log in to take attendance, release their course notes. And for the students, apart from the classroom features, they can check their results and do some online tests. And of course, the most important people, the parents who are paying money for their kids. We have features for them to monitor the child activities. They have like a feedback log on the app. It's basically a school management system. Everything your admin does in school. In Nigeria, we've built a product to make that process seamless and easy, and also being able to track it. Personally, I'm on my journey to being a project manager or a technical product manager. I'm still in the front end phase. I'm hoping by the end of the year, I start shadowing the back-end guys on my team. I believe in live experiences, so I already have two people. I've told them that by the end of this year, guy, I'm your intern. I'm collecting salary, but I'm your intern by the end of this year.
But that's so humble in a way. You're like, you're still willing to go to square one and like learn everything you need to know about the new thing. And I think people want to take that on for sure. That's a great attitude to have, right?
Thank you. Absolutely. So I'm going to shadow the back-end guys, and if I'm still here in the next 3 years, my project manager, I'm going to shadow him also. I want to have real life experience.
There you go. I cannot wait for you, but I think this is going to be a process, but I think you will get there simply because you are determined. You know the path, and you're working hard enough to get, you know, through each of the steps. So it's just a matter of time, right? I think that's the nice thing to hear from your own story. Daphnie Ozioma, thank you so much for being on Educative Sessions and being on our show. And, you know, we'd love, you know, for you to maybe come back again, and certainly want to share this with the rest of the EdPressa community and all that you've accomplished there. I also want to thank everybody who's been watching us on YouTube or listening to us on various podcasting apps. Thank you so much as well. If you want to learn a little bit more about Daphnie's contributions to EdPresso, or if you want to learn about Educative in general, you can check us out at educative.io. And for all of us here at Educative, you know, thank you so much and happy learning. Bye-bye now.
Thank you.
Hope you enjoyed that session. This episode is available on YouTube and also on many podcast platforms. If you'd like to be part of Educative Sessions, the form is open now to apply via the link below. You can also email me at lee@educative.io. Lastly, don't forget to like and comment on our content. Be sure to subscribe for us as well. And of course, you can learn more about us at educative.io. Happy learning.